How's it going?
Finally!
What's that one there? Should help.
My blade.
Stygius, you're revealing your past. All set.
Pal, thanks again for that nectar bottle from before. Stuff just goes right through me like you won't believe. Though I hope you're not going around giving that stuff away to every bozo you know.
What, Skelly? You worry something bad is going to happen if I express a bit of generosity from time to time through our somewhat illicit gift-giving custom around here?
No, I'm worried you'll be wasting your time. If you give that stuff away, don't expect to get anything back. Well, not after the first time, anyway. Usually. I'm just saying, don't get your hopes up.
Maybe I just want to show thanks to my friends for its own sake.
Sure!
I can take on Father now using extreme measures, if I so dare. All right, one more time.
Something here, man. It's been a bit of a long haul, but you are getting closer to the surface and you'll get there someday, and we're with you, however long it takes, okay?
You're nothing. More witches?
To come here have repeatedly been thwarted by good kin. However, we have caused such violence in the intervening time that we must take this as a real victory. Let us continue for however long it takes.
The war is on.
Okay.
Hello, sir.
So all this time, Prince, when you were battling up to the surface and all that, you were searching for her, weren't you? The Queen?
I was. Although, between us, sir, it's important that you keep that one a secret, please. Did you happen to meet her ever?
Well, just the one time, briefly, when your father decided to put me here. And you have my word, of course, about the surface stuff. I got you covered.
Thank you, mate.
Keep fighting, Prince.
Prespus. Deadlier than ever.
Man, I thought we were close as grapes upon the vine, but I was wrong?
Didn't have much choice.
You win this time, and I am good as grapes.
Cheers, mate. Charon's shop. Guess you're doing business.
Into a boat of more substantial size if he's to keep up with my work, my kin.
Nice. Charon, as I know you serve the realm, I just wanted to say I look forward to continuing to work with you in a somewhat more official capacity. I'll still be breaking out of here like always, but, well, you've probably heard. Appreciate your support. I bet Tisiphone's up. Guess not.
Your mother has returned to us already, Zacharias. And still you're going to keep battling your way out, past me and everything up there. Why?
Father says there's no escape from here, and I like to repeatedly show him he's wrong. Besides, I think getting out there a bit from time to time does me some good.
Sounds like you found yourself a steady line of work. Most jobs just need doing. If this one gives you some fulfillment, stick to it. Now, come on.
did it. Stygius shuddered as I picked it up. Extra gemstones. The Vanquisher's Keep.
Already made it up, Tartarus.
I see you, Tartarus. Getting warmer. Fishing point there. Station. Spread us. Steady now. Eurydice.
Come in.
Eurydice, how long have you been down here anyway, if you don't mind my asking? Seems like you're pretty settled in. It's quite a lovely place.
How long have I been down here, huh? Huh, I don't have the faintest. You lose your sense of time once you're a shade, or maybe once there's not a sun or moon over your head. But yeah, I found myself a decent spot and fixed it up a bit. That can be arranged.
So good. Bye.
Bye, hun.
Yourself, in case you haven't noticed, it doesn't count against you when we stop to have these chats. Insisted on that little rule myself.
Don't make me laugh.
Come and get it. Out. use.
Living on Olympus here, I'm surrounded by my family, but I always felt alone. I know that's not the same as your experience, but I'm just saying I relate to what you're going through.
Sold. Thanatos.
Quite a mess you've made here, Zagreus.
You're back. I thought you made it out. No matter.
Stand down.
Now you don't, thanks to me. Seems I'm left to thanking myself, since you're too proud to do it.
I don't know what I'm supposed to say when he gets like this. Should help keep me going. I will keep coming back, just like your stupid heads. Heads for now.
Had enough heat for now, I presume.
Next region. Thank you. who dies first. The last of them. That's a blade.
Something's killing you up there.
You've deduced more or less correctly, Asterius. And yes, let's say there are some challenges remaining once I get out of Elysium, though I'd best say no more of it than that.
That's fine. It's good to know you've fallen just as often as I have. I may not be the one to kill you, but I'll soften you up for whoever does.
Yeah. Olympus, I accept this message.
Yes, what is it this time?
Thanks, sir. Whose favor to choose?
You are so fortunate to have received the boon of Dionysus prior to my own. He, the most noble and important of us all, the god of wine himself.
You shall not goad me into anger with a petty insult such as this, you know. Nevertheless, there is a price which must be paid for it.
Apologies, Lord Ares.
So long, my kin. This one is not worth the pursuit, I think, when we can wage a greater one together.
Splitters.
Permitted in this chamber.
I bet that Charon has to be the life of every feast you have down there with such a personality. Am I not right about that, man?
cheers, mate. Oh, wow.
We've nothing left to say to one another, Hellspawn, other than to battle!
One champion unseated. There's my shade. Hope you enjoyed the show. That was Elysium. Check. Grant me a swift satyr sack. Pay for that.
You hunted down a real bargain there in Keron's shop. Though, how about we try a slightly bigger deal on for size right now?
On. Satyr tunnels. Maybe this way. Yet. Sator. Found it fast this time. Cerberus can never get enough of this stuff.
Oh, great, it's you, Zagreus. Here, let me offer you some fine new boons, as well as Lord Dionysus here, who I'm sure would love to talk your ear off just as much as mine.
Yeah, tells me I'm being awful loud and to back off, all sorts of nasty stuff like that. What can you do though, right?
Phew. Check the other passageways before I go. I can use this. Good enough to eat.
Persuades the underworld's ferocious guardian to move aside.
Thanks, boy. All right, father. Got here as quickly as I could.
That pomegranate blossom. I caught its subtle scent as you approached. The queen has her mother's strength, and much more self-control.
What, you're afraid of a little flower now, father? One that imbues me with the fiercest might of Olympus, granted, but still, it looks harmless at least.
I fear your little flower there much more than you. The queen and her mother, they possess power over life, thus power over death.
Darkness.
us all choose lesser prey.
This can unlock a hidden aspect of my weapons.
Once more, tenacious Zagreus achieves his lofty goal. And just as every time before, except with some sort of new twist of fate, perhaps, he goes a little distance, then he dies.
How?
Did pretty well that time.
Hey, did you see? The Queen's come back! Though did she ever take her sweet time?
Hey, watch it, Hypnos. That's my mother you're talking about.
What, really? Huh. So then your mom doesn't spend any time with you either. We've got something in common.
We don't.
Everyone, look who it is.
Persephone, my queen, it has been far too long. Although the passing of the time was very kind, it is an honor to see you again.
Oh, please, Nyx. No formalities between us, right? It's wonderful to see you too, my friend. The days there on the surface, they were very different, but the nights, I was reminded of our times together here.
Good times, I trust.
Good times, most certainly. I try not to remember the others.
We are pleased to have you back. Although it shall be a difficult adjustment for you once again, I fear. For all of us.
Well, having built a little house all by myself up there, I think I'm up for anything. You know what it's like.
I do.
Tell me something, boy. Zagreus. Why did you do all this? Return the queen. Go to such lengths. At a certain point, you must have learned the way I felt about her. Yet still you persisted. If I were you, I'd not have done me any favors.
I didn't often stop to give it much thought. I just knew I needed to find her. And then as soon as I did, I knew I needed her in my life. In other words, doing you any favors was never a priority, Father. Just ended up that way, I guess.
I see. I appreciate your candor. Nevertheless, I thank you. I do not know how you accomplished what you did, but know that I am grateful for the outcome, even if I failed to act like it most of the time.
You're welcome. Father, I know we can't exactly change the past, but we can try to move forward. Look, I know I'm not even supposed to have this stuff, but everyone likes it. Won't you try it at least? Here, take it either way.
I can dispose of this properly. Speaking of disposal, I've no further need for this here, so rid me of it, why don't you? On your way out.
Father, I don't know what to say.
Your Highness, over here.
What? It isn't much then, but I got you something.
Want me to take that off your hands? Fine. But you are taking this from me. And if anybody asks, we're even. Or scratch that. Don't tell anyone about this. Understand?
Thank you, Than.
So between us, all you're attempting to break out of here, over and over, you're now authorized to keep that up? Exposing weaknesses in underworld security, huh?
Something like that. I guess I've gotten pretty decent about escaping from a place that's known for being inescapable. Let me keep in touch with the other side of the family. Work with you from time to time.
I have to say, I never thought I'd hear you talking about looking forward to working, Zag. You feeling all right? Spending too much time on the surface, maybe?
Oh, I'm feeling fine. I never thought I was much good at anything, but if my fated purpose is to be a master of frustrating father's efforts to make everything strictly perfect, I think I'm okay with that.
Well then, I'll be looking forward to working with you in a more official capacity, even if we're still supposed to keep it all under wraps, for sake of appearances. See you out there.
Bye, Than.
As you may know, lad, I have a connection to the weapons that you use, having once wielded one of them myself. Of course, not knowing its significance back then, but I digress. Sometimes it, well, it keeps in touch, and I have a vision from it to impart.
Oh, do you mean a vision from Varatha, the Eternal Spear? That's out of the ordinary, and also a bit concerning. So what did you see?
Well, I saw a great bearded warrior, bigger than me, pitch black hair, bearing an aspect of Varatha unlike any with which I'm familiar. Then he was gone. But what still lingered were these words. I see you through the eyes of the Crimson Phoenix.
I see you through the eyes of the Crimson Phoenix. I don't understand. What's that supposed to mean?
There's one more thing. This was not my first such vision. Long ago, I saw one of Varatha's other bearers. It was you. Your infernal arms. They must be weapons of the Fates' design. They know already who shall brandish them. Now they ask a favor. Seek Varatha. Speak the words. Go.
I see you through the eyes of the Crimson Phoenix.
Prince, so is it really true then that you're staying and that you'll be working here officially, I guess?
Well, when you put it that way, yes, I guess it is. We're going to try and make it work like this for now.
Well, you know what that means, don't you? We're official co-workers now. Isn't that so exciting? We can share our latest learnings, compare notes about the challenges we're up against, run into one another in the hall.
Do so. We've been doing everything you said this entire time.
But it is not the same. The entire feel of it's completely different now. You'll see. So, okay, bye!
Bye. Mate, if you don't mind, I'd love it if you told me more about your muse.
My muse? Never has somebody been as splendorous as my Eurydice. She was so gentle, yet so stout of heart that it would make yours ache just thinking on it. She inspired innumerable songs of mine.
Eurydice? I know her. Anyway, she must have been a real catch. I'm sorry for your loss. I have to go look into something here.
Thank you for listening, my friend. Eurydice, she likewise used to listen to me all the time.
Just so I understand. Breaking through everything in your path, taking resources from your father's realm, trying to get through me. All officially part of the job description.
I guess that's right. But before you ask, I'm not doing it for him.
I didn't think you'd have it in you to leave this place for good. But I didn't think you'd take responsibility for anything either. Anyway, we'll just have to kill each other more officially, I guess.
We'll make it official, all right. Freshly caught, just for you, Chef. Fair market value. I've come for questionable deals. What are those shades muttering about?